Hello guys and welcome back. So I have just finished my preview for the upcoming season for the Washington Capitals, and right now we will do the second season preview, and this time it will be about Boston Bruins, another very strong team in the newly created Eastern Division. So let's look at the last three seasons for the Boston Bruins. 17-18, they were able to score 112 points. The year after, they scored 107 points. And the last season, they were projected to finish the season after the full 82 games schedule with a grand total of 117 points. So also a great season last year for the Boston Bruins. Last season and the statistics from the last season, both of the special teams really good for the Bruins. Power play clicking at 25.22%. That was actually second best in the league right after the Edmonton Oilers. And power a penalty kill 84.26%. That was the third best in the league. So very good special teams for the Boston Bruins. One of the biggest threats for the Bruins were these absolutely great special teams. Goals for the Bruins, 3.24, that was ninth best in the league, and goals against 2.39, that was the best in the league. So that's why also the goaltending tandem, Rask and Halak, received the Jennings Award for the best goaltending tandem in the whole of the NHL. So really great defense from the Bruins in the last season. But right now, we are coming to a very, very negative aspect for the Boston Bruins heading into the 2020-2021 season, and that being that both Marchand and Pastrňák are currently on the injured reserve. So they are projected to return. Marchand, I do believe he's projected to return in the mid of January, so maybe he will be able to start from the beginning of the season, but Pastrňák, he should be back, I do believe, in the middle of February, it was said. So they will be missing for some time, Marchand maybe even not, but Pastrňák definitely for a couple of weeks. So that could be a great downside for the Boston Bruins, and I think that how they will manage to play potentially against Marchand and Pastrňák for the couple of weeks, that could determine where the Boston Bruins will finish in the Eastern Division. So I have them currently first in the East, I have them that they are best team in the Eastern Division. I have projected them to finish as the best team in the Eastern Division, but there is big but. If they will able to play also at that highest level without Marchand and Pastrňák for some weeks in the beginning of this season. And also injured is Miller, who is also a UFA after this season. Cap hit for the Bruins, 78 million, or basically over 78 million, so it's pretty stabilized, you know. They are not over it, so that is great news for the general manager of the Boston Bruins, Don Sweeney. And let's look at the roster right now. Okay, so the first line, Marchand, Bergeron and Pastrňák, whenever they will be fully ready to go. So this is according to Daily Faceoff. I have all these roster things. I get them from the dailyfaceoff.com. Definitely a great site. I advise also you to check it out. So Marchand, Bergeron and Pastrňák, they are projected to be the first, so the best in the league, the best first line in the league. So they are basically the best line in hockey currently in the earth, according to Daily Faceoff, of course. And I think Marchand, Bergeron, Pastrňák, totally just a great line, and it's very hard to play against these guys. The second line, Debrask, Krejci and Kaše, that's projected to be 19th in the league. The third line, in the, you know, with Bjork, Coyle and Smith, that is projected to be actually second best third line in the league, so pretty good. Third line with Bjork, Coyle and Smith, and the fourth line, Ricci, Kurali and Wagner, that is projected to be the 17th best fourth line in the league. Let's look at the defensive pairing, and here is where the problem could emerge for the Boston Bruins potentially, because this offensive group, I think it's pretty good, providing of course that Pastrňák and Marchand will not be that long on that injured reserve. But on the defensive part of the game, Boston Bruins in this offseason, they have lost Zdeno Chara, who of course just a few days ago has signed with Washington Capitals, but also probably most importantly, they have lost Tori Krug, who came to St. Louis Blues. So Tori Krug, that could be a huge loss for the Bruins, because of course Krug was a very important part of the Boston Bruins power play. They had over 25%. They were second best in the league. So Tori Krug will be missed in Boston, definitely. So the defensive pairings for the Bruins. The first defensive pairing is Matt Grizzlick alongside Charlie McAvoy. That is projected by Daily Faceoff to be the sixth best first defensive pair in the league. The second defensive pairing is Lauzon and Carlo. That's projected to be 16th best in the league. And the third defensive pairing is Moore alongside Clifton. That is projected to be 11th in the league. But I think the Boston Bruins definitely could be having some issues in the defensive part of the game. But we must not forget about the goalies. Tuukka Rask and Jaroslav Halak, one of the best, if not the best, defensive or goaltending tandem in the league, in the NHL. But what's the problem with goaltending in the Boston Bruins, in the Boston, is that, as you can see, Rask and also Jaroslav Halak, they are, after this season, they are UFAs. So some problems emerging for the Bruins. They will have to try to keep at least one of them into Boston. I think preferably Don Sweeney would probably prefer to keep Tuukka Rask and maybe let Jaroslav Halak go. But I think if he will try to negotiate also with Jaro, maybe he will agree to a little bit lower salary, a lower cap hit. But we'll see. But definitely this is a issue emerging for the Bruins, both of the goaltenders that have won recently. Jennings Zavard for the least goals against in the whole of the NHL, both of them are UFAs, so that's the problem for the Bruins, definitely. And Don Sweeney will have some work to do here. And also, Sean Corrali is UFA and David Krejci, UFA. So, actually, four UFAs or five with Miller also, who is currently injured. He will be also UFA. So, a couple of UFAs actually in Boston, and also a couple of RFAs, as you can see, restricted free agent after this season will be Brandon Carlo, a very important part of the Boston defense. Also, Matt Ritchie playing probably in the fourth line, and Andre Kasha, both of these players, Kasha and Ritchie, of course, coming from Anaheim Ducks to the Boston Bruins a couple of months ago. So yeah, this is the Boston Bruins lineup, and my prediction, as I have already said, is that Boston will finish first in the Eastern Division, but we will see. As I have said earlier, I think it will all depend on how the Boston Bruins and the team of Bruce Cassidy will be able to cope with the loss of David Pastrnak and potentially Brad Marchand in the beginning of the season. These are huge losses for the Boston Bruins. Pastrnak and Marchand, the two of the guys from the first line, that would be crucial. How Boston would be able to play, basically, when Marchand and Pastrnak will not be available. But I still think that Boston has some great players in lineup, and I think they should be capable of winning the Eastern Division. However, it definitely will not be easy. So we'll see. That's the preview for the Boston Bruins for the upcoming 2021 NHL season. I hope you did enjoy it. If you did, definitely please subscribe. It would mean a lot to me, guys. And leave a like down below and comment also down below. How do you think the Boston will do in this upcoming 2021 season? If you consider them to be one of the biggest favorites to win the Stanley Cup, or if you think that with the loss of Zdeno Chara and Tori Krug, and potentially with losing Pastrnak and Marchand for some couple of weeks in the beginning of the season, if you think that they just wouldn't be able to basically compete with teams like Tampa, with teams like Colorado, definitely leave a comment down below, and I'm looking forward to reading your thoughts, guys, and thank you very much for watching this video once again. Hope you have a wonderful rest of the day. So bye, guys, till now, but I will definitely be talking to you again very, very soon. So bye, guys.